Subscribing to a MemoQ cloud server allows translation teams and companies to have a fully functioning MemoQ server with little setup. To get started, first browse to MemoQ cloud server under the Translation Products tab of the MemoQ website. You can then configure your server to your needs, select the number of Project Manager and Translator Pro licenses that you will need, as well as any server add-ons. Next, enter a name for your server. Under the Cost After Trial Period section, you can see how much your server will cost monthly after your free trial has ended. Once you're happy with your server configurations, either sign in with your language terminal profile or register if you've not already done so. Next, you'll be taken to your cloud server subscription page in the My Account section of the website, where you can manage your cloud server, add or remove licenses, schedule backups, and more. It will take a few moments for your cloud server to be ready, and once it is, you will receive an email notification telling you so. You should then change the admin password in order to ensure security. This can be done under the Tasks section of your profile. Once it's ready, you can then get started with connecting to your MemoQ server. To do so in the MemoQ client, you first must retrieve your Mobile Project Manager license from the server. Select the blue MemoQ tab and click on Activation Wizard. Select the option, I wish to configure CAL. Enter your server URL, select Test, and then enter the admin username and password. After you press Next, MemoQ will give you a Project Manager license from your server. After retrieving your license, restart MemoQ, and you will then see the Project Manager interface of your dashboard. Enter your server URL into the box below Dashboard and press the check mark. Before you begin creating projects, select the Server Administrator icon to create usernames and assign licenses. Each user who will work on your server will need a unique username and password, so to create one, select the User Management tab. Here you will see all of the users that have been created on the server. To create a new user, select the Add button and fill in the appropriate information. You can even add your user to a group, which is related to rights outside of a project. Once the username has been created, it will then appear along with the other usernames on your server. To assign a mobile license to another user, select the CAL license tab. To manually assign a license, select the Assign to User Groups tab. There, you can choose their name or group from the drop-down list, set the expiration date, and choose the type of license. Once you press Grant, that user will then be able to retrieve a license through the Activation Wizard and use until the expiration date you have set. You can also assign licenses by computer name or use the Project Permissions option, which gives a user working in a project the right to retrieve a license if they need it. After assigning licenses, you are now ready to begin creating a project. Select the New Project drop-down list and either choose New Online Project from Template or New Online Project. Choosing the online options publishes the project to the server as opposed to on your local computer. Select a name for your project, the source and target languages, and choose the settings needed. Once created, you will see the main translation panel of the project. Select Import to add your file or files to translate. Once it has been added, you will see the file name, number of words, a progress bar that updates in real time, and the three workflow steps, Translator, Reviewer 1, and Reviewer 2. Before assigning a user to the file, you must first assign them to the project. Select the People panel and choose the Add Users button. Add all of the users who will be working with the project, and once done, you will see their names with three boxes next to it. If the user should have PM rights, make sure the Project Manager box is checked. If you'd like MemoQ to automatically assign the user a license, In order to work in the memoQ client, ensure the box under Desktop License is checked. This license will last for the duration of the project. After you have added all of your users to the project, return to the Translations panel and select the Assign button to assign your users. Choose the assignment option that you would like to use, either single user, group sourcing, first accept, or distribute documents. You can even have memoQ calculate your deadline for you automatically. Once you have assigned your users, you then need to attach your translation memories. To do so, head to the Translation Memory section of the project. Because there are no TMs currently on the server, you will need to select Create Use New to create your first TM. Name your TM and then press OK. It will appear in the Translation Memory section of the project once created. To attach a TM, check the box next to the TM name and memoQ will start pulling matches from it. You can have as many TMs attached to a project as you like, and memoQ will pull matches from all of them. The one designated as your working TM is the TM that will be updated when a translator or a reviewer confirms a segment. And the one designated as your master TM will be updated when a PM confirms the segments or, if using a template, by an automated action at the end of the project. To calculate your reports, head to the Reports section of the project. Under the Analysis section, select Create New Report Now to see the word count and leverage of your project. You can also calculate your analysis in the Translation panel by pressing the Statistics button. Once the files have been assigned and the resources attached, the translation is now ready to begin. Select the Click to Launch Project button to begin the email notification chain and alert your translators that it is time to start. To connect to WebTrans, enter your server URL into the address bar of any browser and press Enter. You will then need to enter your username and password, and once done, you will be able to access memoQ WebTrans, and if you have the appropriate permissions, WebPM and the Admin tab. Here, you can translate files assigned to you, create and manage projects, and manage your users.